A new paper by the World Bank Group suggests that the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, or OPEC's, days may be numbered. This comes after OPEC's refusal to curb oil production, leading to a 9-month plunge in crude oil prices. OPEC's current strategy hinges on the odds that an extended period of low prices will lead other high-cost producers like the US shale oil drillers to scale back output, enabling OPEC to reassert its influence in the market. The paper explains how difficult it can be to maintain a commodities cartel in the face of market forces and technological advances. According to historical data in the paper, a driving factor behind the collapse of the tin cartel in 1985 was the rise of aluminum as a substitute. In 1999, the Asian Rubber Producers Cartel, comprising Indonesia, Malaysia and Thailand, collapsed after 20 years of existence. Rubber prices, which are denominated in US dollars, declined in the late 1990s due to weak demand amid the fallout from the Asian financial crisis. The World Bank notes this should have prompted production cuts. However, the sharp devaluation in the members' currencies caused local prices of rubber to increase, leading producers to expand output. The World Bank reckons unconventional and higher-cost players such as the US shale drillers and even biofuel producers may be the new swing producers in the oil market. However, given that the OPEC isn't governed by a legal clause on how it can intervene in the market, gives it more flexibility to respond to the changing nature of the market. Director of International Economics at the Council of Foreign Relations, Ben Steele, noted that the last time the OPEC was in a similar situation was during the 1980s, when oil prices fell as low as $12 per barrel, which is roughly $27 when adjusted for inflation. And though people proclaimed that the OPEC was dead, it was able to sustain the oil crisis because the fundamental forces of the business settled at a higher level of oil prices, which helped the OPEC regain some relevance.